7 à la banque. 9 à la banque.
I need another 1,000.
I admire your courage, Miss...
Trench. Sylvia Trench. I admire your luck, Mr...
Bond. James Bond.
In an age where idols are breakable, James Bond is indestructible, and our memories of him, unforgettable.
A medium dry martini, lemon peel, shaken, not stirred.
Vodka?
Of course.
My name's Bond. James Bond.
I know who you are, what you are, and why you've come.
My name's Bond. James Bond.
James.
Moneypenny, a feast for my eyes.
Who are you?
My name is Pussy Galore.
I must be dreaming.
You're not trying to take advantage of me, are you?
Thought never crossed my mind.
The Pharaoh.
Voilà, Monsieur. Chateau Latour, 62.
Excellent, Henri, excellent.
We have, of course, the 61.
Yes, I know, a superior vintage. But open the 62 anyway. You see, tonight, Henri, we must have a wine that is precisely 25 years old. Because we are celebrating an anniversary. A rather important one. Thank you. Superb. 1962. That was a year a chap called Bond, James Bond, first appeared in the cinemas. I'd like you to join me tonight in recalling his rather extraordinary life and times. To 007. To 25 years of adventure.
Why are you here?
Bond? James Bond?
Do I know the gentleman?
Well, he knows you.
Without being immodest, there's hardly anyone in this part of the world who doesn't.
And there are very few people who haven't heard of Bond. British Secret Service, 007, licensed to kill. He's good, even by my standards.
It's not a bad life for secret agents. First class travel to the most delightful places. Plenty of variety in the work, no time clock to punch. M, always very generous with the expense. But can't. And one does meet such interesting people. but not, however, the sort you'd invite home to lunch. I've always enjoyed train trips. Gives you a chance to get your thoughts together. Rather crowded and noisy in there.
Mr. Bond, it's good to see you again.
Rail travel is not what it used to be.
One can't get through life without meeting a few disagreeable people, I suppose. But the ones 007's likely to meet on a train or in the street, usually rather straightforward chaps. Kill or be killed, that's their game. It's their masters one has to worry about. They all wear their power and their villainy as if it were some rather rare and expensive aftershave. Subtle, unmistakable, unforgettable.
Remove his helmet. James Bond, allow me to introduce myself. I am Ernst Stavro Blofeld. They told me you were assassinated in Hong Kong.
Yes, this is my second life.
You only live twice, Mr. Bond.
May I press you to a cucumber sandwich?
Thank you, no, nothing at all.
Am I too soon?
Not at all. I'm sure Mr. Bond is eager to start his tour. Miss Dufour will escort you to Dr. Goodhead, who will show you round.
Ask anything you like.
Thank you for being so cooperative.
A pleasure. Look after Mr. Bond. See that some harm comes to him.
You persist in trying to provoke me, Mr. Bond. I could have had you killed in the swamp.
And why didn't you?
I thought you less stupid. Usually when a man gets in my way.
You are a clever, resourceful man, Mr. Bond.
Why, thank you.
Perhaps too clever. Twice our paths have crossed. Let's leave it at that. I should think our first meeting would have convinced you.
Oh, I see. You're worried about me not giving you a return game.
Both of us know perfectly well what we are talking about, Mr. Bond. But I see that it is necessary to remind you. Our job. Many people have tried to involve themselves in my affairs, unsuccessfully.
Remarkable. But what does a club secretary have to say?
Oh, nothing, Mr. Bond. I own the club.
Play, Mr. Bond. You need a great deal of luck to get out of this.
Oh, luck? Well, then I shall use player's privilege and use your lucky dice. It's all in the wrist. Double sixes. Fancy that. 200,000 rupees. I prefer cash.
Get it cashed for him.
Yes, sir.
Spend the money quickly. Mr. Bond.
I intend to, Kamal Khan.
Doesn't do to trust to luck when dealing with that crowd. You need the best possible imaginable weaponry, or the best possible unimaginable weaponry. And for that, 007 relies on Q. Bit of a genius. Bit of a fusspot, too. Never thinks the agent in the field can understand his gadgets or take proper care of them. And that's ridiculous. They're all so simple to use. That's the beauty of them. Excuse me. Q, could you step in here for a moment, please?
Now, pay attention, please. Windscreen bulletproof, as are the side and the rear windows. Revolving number plates naturally. Valid all countries. Now, this one I'm particularly keen about. Whatever you do, don't touch it.
No, why not?
Because you release this section of the roof and engage and fire the passenger ejector seat.
Ejector seat? You're joking.
I never joke about my work, 007. I want that ready for Ackman's tea party.
Ah, there you are, 007.
Balls, Q.
Bolus, 007. Good. Have that ready for Army Day.
Yes, sir.
Q. Smithers, how's the arm?
Coming along very nicely, thank you, sir.
That'll come in handy.
This is now being issued as standard equipment. Strap it on your wrist. It's activated by nerve impulses from the wrist muscles.
Like this?
Oh, thank you, 007.
Be careful, will you?
Yes, Keith.
10 dots. 5 blue-tipped with armor-piercing heads, 5 red-tipped, cyanide-coated, causing death in 30 seconds.
Very novel, Q. You must get them in the stores for Christmas.
Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for the rest. Nobody does it.
Major Boothroyd.
Morning, Major.
Look what Q's brought for us. Isn't it nice?
Right. Now, pay attention, 007. I want you to take great care of this equipment. There are one or two rather special accessories.
Q, have I ever let you down?
Frequently.
All 007's major enemies had this in common. They lived beyond our means, beyond our wildest dreams, for that matter. They also shared this belief that money can and should buy unhappiness for the entire world. At the command of their low cunning was the highest technology. To combat such sophisticated power, you need more than weapons or brute strength.
Here we are, sir. Human poisoning from native plants.
Good work, Tambor. Oh, this is a first edition.
I'm afraid it's the best we can do, sir.
Any chance of finding the 74 printing?
There's a footnote in Appendix B I'm particularly keen on.
I'll have a look, Caesar.
Thank you, Tam. The secret life of a secret agent. Exciting, isn't it? But if power is knowledge, then it stands to reason that the powerful must be exceedingly knowledgeable. Won't do for 007 just to keep up with his enemies. He must be ahead of them. And it doesn't do him any harm around the Home Office either.
Ah, there you are, 007.
Minister, Chief of Staff.
Are you aware of our ATAC system, 007?
ATAC, sir? Automatic Targeting Attack Communicator. Uses an ultra-low frequency coded transmitter to order our submarines to launch ballistic missiles.
It's a chemical formula of a plant. Orchidea nigra. A very rare orchid indeed.
Yes, it was thought to be extinct until a missionary brought one back from the upper reaches of the Amazoco.
Actually, he brought it back from the area of the River Tipperary.
Well done, James.
Good morning, Sir Donald. This is Commander Bond.
How do you do, Commander Bond?
Sir.
Please sit down.
Thank you.
Sherry?
Not from me, thanks. Doctor's orders.
Commander Bond?
Yes, thank you.
You've been on holiday, I understand. Relaxing, I hope.
Oh, hardly relaxing, but most satisfying.
Well, cheers. Cheers.
Pity about your liver, sir. An unusually fine Solera. 51, I believe.
There is no year for sherry, 007.
I was referring to the original vintage on which the sherry is based, sir. 1851. Don't mistake it.
Precisely.
Do you know what this is? Well, it looks like a Fabergé egg, sir. One of the jewel eggs made by Carl Fabergé as an Easter gift for the Russian royal family. They're priceless and very rare. This one contains a model of the Imperial State Coach.
Hmm. Top marks, 007.
Do you like Japanese sake, Mr. Bond? Or would you prefer vodka martini?
Oh, no. I like sake. Especially when it's served at the correct temperature. 98.4 degrees Fahrenheit, like this is.
For a European, you are exceptionally cultivated.
Tell me, Commander, how far does your expertise extend into the field of diamonds?
Well, how does substance found in nature, the cut glass, suggest marriage? I suppose I've replaced a dog as a girl's best friend, and that's about it.
Refreshing to hear there's one subject you're not an expert on.
Diamonds. You think you can dig me something up on diamonds, their grading and distribution?
If you would just wait a moment, sir.
Next time I'll do. You see, there's some information you can't get out of books. Sometimes there's simply no substitution for a field trip.
My relationship with a client, Mr. Bond, is strictly confidential. Like a doctor, priest with a penitent.
Of course. Yet you make guns for fingerless hoodlums, bullets for assassins.
Mr. Bond, bullets do not kill. It is the finger that pulls the trigger.
Exactly. I'm now aiming precisely at your groin. So speak or forever hold your peace.
Mr. Bond, this is impossible. I cannot.
You're quite right. An inch too low.
I have just completed an order for immediate delivery.
Who are you?
My name is Bond. James Bond.
Is there something I can do for you?
Yes, a matter of fact, there is. There is something I'd like you to get off your chest. Where is Ernst Stavro Blofeld? Speak up, darling, I can't hear you.
Where's Peckish? Where's Peckish?
Pyramids!
Ah! What a helpful chap.
Yes.
Is it here?
What?
The decoding machine, Elector.
Must we talk about it now?
Or is it at the Russian consulate?
Yes.
I would need a plan of the place. If you could get one, we could meet at the San Sofia Mosque, like we were tourists.
Why don't you ask me that later?
All work and no play would have made James a very dull boy indeed. And a much poorer man. Well, poor in memories, that is. It wouldn't do to sit about brooding on the ugly side of a secret agent's life. Fortunately, unpleasant memories fade. But the lovely moments, they seem to grow more brightly with each passing year. It's a pity some of those sweet encounters were so brief.
Good evening. I wondered when you might arrive.
So you are the mysterious octopus.
And you are James Bond, 007, licensed to kill. Am I to be your target for tonight?
Well, not necessarily.
Oh!
Hello.
Aren't you in the wrong room, Mr. Bond?
Not from where I'm standing.
Since you are here, would you mind giving me something to put on?
Weren't you a blonde when I came in?
Could be.
I tend to notice little things like that. Whether a girl is a blonde or a brunette.
And which do you prefer?
Oh, providing the collars and cuffs match.
We'll talk about that later. Let me have your glass. I'll get you some ice.
Of course, sometimes 007's reception was a bit on the cool side. It's a pity that certain people didn't take a little more time to get to know him better.
Well, hi there. I'm Bambi.
Good morning, Bambi.
And I'm Thumper. Is there something we can do for you?
I can think of several things offhand, but...
I've got you now.
Well, enjoy yourself.
Who are you working for?
Empire Chemicals, you know that.
You are a liar. Do you know what this is?
I'd rather not.
Plastic surgeons call it a dermatome. They use it to slice off skin. I hope you won't force me to use it.
Why do Chinese girls taste different from all other girls?
You think we better, huh?
No, just different. Like Peking duck is different from Russian caviar, but I love them both.
Darling, I give you very best duck.
Well, that'd be lovely. We've had some interesting times together, Ling. I'd be sorry to go. What would it take for you to see things my way?
A lot more than you've got.
How do you know?
I don't want to know.
Isn't it customary to grant the condemned man his last request?
You've asked for this. Get up.
Certainly.
Now let's both play.
Those cards. It is a blasphemy. They tell nothing to those who cannot see.
Oh, but they do. That's a bit of luck. Good luck for both of us. The cards say we will be lovers. Pick one.
Before it was given. Strangely enough, somehow, so did I.
Looking at an industrial laser, which emits an extraordinary light not to be found in nature. It can project a spot on the moon, or at closer range, cut through solid metal. I will show you. This is gold, Mr. Bond. All my life, I've been in love with its color, its brilliance, its divine heaviness. I welcome any enterprise that will increase my stock, which is considerable.
I think you've made your point, Goldfinger. Thank you for the demonstration.
Choose your next witticism carefully, Mr. Bond. It may be your last. The purpose of our two previous encounters is now very clear to me. I do not intend to be distracted by another. Good night, Mr. Bond.
Do you expect me to talk?
No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to die.
Astonishing, isn't it? The imagination they lavish on the problem of eliminating 007. If there's a bizarre way of trying to get rid of him, you can always count on someone having a go at it. It's a compliment of sorts. Well, I suppose it's a way of saying that an extraordinary life deserves an extraordinary death. One could only wish they weren't quite so relentless about it. There you are. Typical, I'm sorry to say. I'd like something on the side as well. Information. Three men and a girl came in.
They live and let die.
Live and let die.
Evil always underestimates us. Counts on the members of Her Majesty's Secret Service to be gentlemen, play by the rules, that sort of thing. Like to oblige, but our enemies have an unfortunate habit of making up their own rules as they go along, and breaking even those when it suits them. That's why 007 is licensed to kill. But he's also licensed to improvise, because sometimes actions speak louder than licenses.
A pity you leave us. Such good sport.
Unless you're a pheasant.
Oh, really, Mr. Bond? Take my gun, a stray bird may fly over.
I only stopped to thank you for your hospitality.
I'm afraid it will get you to the airport in plenty of time. Come now.
I doubt if I'm in your class.
Oh, you're too modest, Mr. Bond. Over there. You missed, Mr. Bond.
Did I? As you said, such good sport.
Varga's behind you.
Really?
He must have followed us.
I think he got the point.
Left this with Ferrara, I believe.
Fresh air, fresh snow, healthy outdoor exercise. Well, even
007 deserves a holiday now and again. Unfortunately, this isn't it. It's more like a training course. You see, an agent never knows what particular skill is going to be required in his job, and on a moment's notice at that. He has to be a jack of all the dangerous trades, a master of them too. In the world of James Bond, it's not enough to be good. You have to be the best. You never know when your life is going to depend upon it, even on a nice day like this in Stuttgart. The forces of evil usually command the big battalions. Hacking your way through them is hard and dangerous work. And even when one's finished with it, there's a final task to be accomplished. The sleek princes of destruction must be tracked down to their lairs, confronted in their arrogance, and terminated with maximum prejudice. Evil should have only one life.
Everyone knows he has 9. And James Bond.
I shall have the pleasure of putting you out of my misery. Desolated Mr. Bond.
Heartbroken, Mr. Drax. Allow me. Take a giant step for mankind.
In The Living Daylights, the 15th James Bond film, Timothy Dalton makes his debut as 007.
It's all so boring here, Margot. If only I could find a real man.
She'll call you back.
Who are you?
Bond, James Bond.
To portray a classic hero, the producers turned to a classically trained actor, Timothy Dalton. A distinguished star of the British stage, international films and television, he brings his own special interpretation to the role of James Bond.
He's a man that fulfills a lot of fantasies, I think probably both male and female. Whether you call them strengths or weaknesses, I mean, hard drinking, hard smoking, hard driving, womanizing. If you're working as a secret agent, you can't become emotionally involved. But having set that up, that hard side to the man's character, he then always had a moment of vulnerability when he fell for a woman.
Don't. It's impossible. Knowing you only 2 days, and all I can think of is how we would be together.
Don't think. Just let it happen.
The Living Daylights takes Timothy Dalton across 3 continents and through the twists and turns of a complex tale of international intrigue. His adventures are as imaginative and exotic as any that James Bond has ever faced.
And I'm very, very fond of the Ian Fleming books. And there's a fairly clear understanding to be gained of Bond from those books. You know, the man is a complex man. He's a man who lives very much on the edge of his life, constantly surrounded by the threat of being killed.
This time, hold it steady.
Where are you going?
To drop a bomb.
James Bond. After 25 years, the adventure continues.